Good morning students, our next concept is quadrilateral formed by the pair of straight lines S denoted with S, AX square plus 2HXY plus BY square is equal to 0 and S dash is AX square plus 2HXY plus BY square plus 2GX plus 2FY plus C is equal to 0. Okay, see here. So actually this is two pair of straight lines, this is two pair of straight lines, okay? So these two pair of straight lines, by these two pair of straight lines, it forms a quadrilateral. That quadrilateral may be parallelogram, rectangle, square or rhombus, any one of them you can get, okay? So based on some conditions you may get different quadrilaterals. See here. Out of this, equation of diagonal passing through the origin is, so that means, so I am drawing here, this is these two pair of straight lines represented by AX square plus 2HXY plus BY square is equal to 0. This is for suppose origin 0 comma 0. So this is these two represented by the pair of straight lines S dash is equal to 0. That means AX square plus 2HXY plus BY square plus 2GX plus 2F plus C is equal to 0. Okay. See here, if you want to find the equation of diagonal passing through origin. So this is the diagonal passing through origin. Okay. This is the diagonal passing through, not passing through origin. Okay. See here, if you want to find out the equation of diagonal passing through origin is y is equal to gh minus af by hf minus bz by x. Y is equal to gh minus af by hf minus bz into x. Y is equal to gh minus af by hf minus bz into x. Actually, I gave here the point of intersection of the pair of straight lines AX square plus 2HXY plus BY square plus 2GX plus 2F plus C is equal to 0 is HF minus BZ by AB minus H square. Next one, GH minus AF by AB minus H square. For this straight line, origin. For this pair of straight lines, origin. So the equation which is passing through origin and having slope. What is the slope of this line? This is x1, y1. This is x2, y2. So y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So what is the slope of this one? Gh minus af by ab minus h square by hf minus bz by ab minus h square. This ab minus h square cancel. So what you have? Gh minus af by hf minus bz. So so this is the slope of the line. Passing through origin formula is y is equal to mx. So y is equal to gh minus af by hf minus bz into x. That is one of the answer. Y is equal to gh minus af by hf minus bz into x. Next one is the equation of diagonal not passing through origin is S dash minus S is equal to 0. That is 2GX plus 2FY plus C is equal to 0. See here. So if you want to find out the diagonal not passing through origin, to get that one, so this is S dash, this is S. So X square and XY term, Y square terms both are equal. So S dash minus S is equal to what you get? So these three terms will get cancelled. So remaining we have 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. That is the equation. That is the equation of the diagonal not passing through origin. So 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. Okay. Next one is, if the diagonals are perpendicular, see here, if these two are perpendicular. Okay. If these two are perpendicular, then the condition is h into f square minus g square plus a minus b into fg is equal to 0. So it is like h into x square minus y square is equal to a minus b into x by like that. It is the formula. Okay, so you can remember like that. It's not exactly. So h into f square minus g square plus a minus b into fg is equal to 0. Proof of this one is, so actually, so if for suppose these two are perpendicular to each other, these two diagonals, what is the slope of this diagonal? GH minus AF by HF minus BC. Okay, what is the slope of this diagonal? So what is the line equation non-passing through origin? The diagonal non-passing through origin is nothing but 2GX plus 2FI plus C is equal to 0. So slope is nothing but minus 2G by minus 2F. Minus 2G by 2F. 2 get cancelled, we have minus G by F. Because of these two are perpendicular, their product of slopes is equal to minus 1. So GH minus AF by HF minus BZ into minus G by F is equal to minus 1. So if you simplify, so G, this minus minus get cancelled. Otherwise you can multiply also, no problem. Minus G into GH minus GH, G square H minus into minus plus AFG is equal to this total term multiplied to this minus 1. So here, this minus 1 into HF into F, that means minus HF square and minus into minus plus BZ into F, so BZF. So this minus HF square transpose this side, that gives plus HF square, and you take H common, then we have F square plus F square minus G square, and this BZF transpose this side, that is minus BZF, and you can take GF common from these two terms. So after taking G of that are F into G, no problem, FG, then we have here A, and after this transpose this side, we have minus B. So A minus B into FG is equal to 0. So this is the answer for that question. So H into F square minus G square plus A minus B into FG is equal to 0. Okay, these three points are very, very important. So now based on this one, I can conclusion for this one. So which quadrilaterals they may form? They may form means, so name of quadrilateral condition. You just remember, so here whenever ax square plus 2hx square plus by square, and here ax square plus 2hx square plus by square, these three terms are equal, means here the pair of straight lines of this one and the pair of straight lines of this one are parallel to each other. That means obviously that forms a parallelogram. Okay, obviously forms a parallelogram. See here, square means a plus b is equal to 0, because of square means what? So here ax square, a plus b is equal to 0. Here also, if a plus b is equal to 0, then these two straight lines, these two pair of straight lines perpendicular to each other, and these two also perpendicular to each other. So automatically these two also perpendicular, so it forms a square or rectangle if a plus b is equal to 0, because angle between x and sides is equal to 90 degrees means that may be square or rectangle in two possibilities. Okay, so square means a plus b is equal to 0, and square means diagonals also perpendicular to each other. If diagonals also perpendicular to each other, what is the condition? H into f square minus g square plus a minus b into fg is equal to 0. So I just give one small information about the quadrilaterals. If angle between adjacent sides 90 and adjacent sides is 90, then they forms either square or rectangle. If diagonals perpendicular to each other, then they forms rhombus or square. You just remember this. Okay, so square means a plus b is equal to 0, h into f square minus g square plus a minus b into fg is equal to 0. Rectangle means a plus b is equal to 0, but in rectangle diagonals not perpendicular to each other. So you can get h into f square minus g square plus a minus b into fg is not equal to 0. Parallelogram. Parallelogram means adjacent sides angle also not 90, and diagonals also non-perpendicular. So a plus b not equal to 0, and h into f square minus g square plus a minus b into fg also not equal to 0. And rhombus. So rhombus means adjacent sides between angle between adjacent sides is not 90. That means those are not perpendicular. So a plus b is not equal to 0, and diagonals perpendicular to each other. So h into f square minus g square plus a minus b into fg is equal to 0. So if you follow these four conditions, so we can decide the given two pair of straight lines s and s dash, which type of quadrilateral they form. Okay, see, based on this one question, area of above quadrilateral is, so I am going to discussing with which area of the quadrilateral. So based on these these two pair of straight lines, these two pair of straight lines. Okay, so area of the quadrilateral, above quadrilateral, is nothing but modulus of C by 2 into root over h square minus ab. Modulus of C by root 2 into root over h square minus ab. Actually, I gave this formula, area of the quadrilateral is equal to P1 P2 by sine theta, where P1 P2 are nothing but product of the perpendiculars from origin to ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. Okay, product of the, here P1 P2 is nothing but product of perpendiculars from origin to ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to, already I gave this formula in coordinate system, P1 P2 by sine theta formula. Okay, just remember, if you don't know, just remember here P1 P2 are nothing but product of perpendiculars from origin to pair of straight lines, ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. So now go to formula, applying formula, P1 P2 is nothing but what you get, P1 P2 product of perpendiculars, already I gave the formula. So what is the formula? From origin, see, so if you take origin as alpha comma beta, okay, then product of perpendiculars formula is what, a alpha square plus 2h alpha beta plus b beta square plus 2z alpha plus 2f beta plus c is equal to c by root over a minus b whole square plus h square, 4h square, that is the formula. Okay, so here alpha comma beta is nothing but 0 comma 0, so it, this term 0, 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 so this is modulus of c by root over a minus b whole square plus 4h square, so that is p1 p2. Okay, modulus of c by root over a minus b whole square plus 4h square. Already I gave the formula, product of perpendiculars from point alpha comma beta to ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. Okay, I gave the formula. So that is nothing but here alpha comma beta is 0 comma 0. So we get mod c by root over a minus b whole square plus 4h square. So this theta is nothing but angle between the these two pair of straight lines, that means angle between these two pair of straight lines. So what is the formula? Angle between those two pair of straight lines, sine theta. According to sine theta, we have the formula 2 times of root over h square minus ab by root over a minus b whole square plus 4h square. I gave the formula already. So here, so this denominator get cancelled, then we have mod c by 2 into root over h square minus ab. This is the formula is important, proof is not important. So just remember how to do this, how to derive this one. Okay, so the area of the quadrilateral formed by s is equal to 0 and s dash is equal to 0 is modulus of c by 2 times of root over h square minus ab. Based on this concept, I give the formulas in next problems in next video.